Hey guys, welcome to the channel. There's some breaking news going on right now, and so for the second day in a row, I'm going to be doing kind of an impromptu live stream. So what is happening right now is that there is a big police and FBI presence at the Carlton Reserve. I'm going to try a couple of different pieces of of technology that I haven't used before. So I'm going to do my very, very best. But I want to kind of tune in to what they're saying over on WFLA, which is a local station there in Florida. They are live streaming now. Their helicopter left about 20 minutes ago. So I'm backing up to where the helicopter was actually at the reserve. So let's go ahead and jump in there real quick right now.
Yakahatchee Creek Environmental Park. So that area, so that is where the vehicle exactly was found here. And we did get some answers here from police as far as exactly what that transpires to. The time, by the way, on that, the timestamp, 2:42 in the afternoon. And I want to read this here for you folks from WFLA.com.
So I'm going to turn this down just a little bit here. Basically, what is happening in the Carlton Reserve is there are two sets of cars. That white van that you're seeing there on the right hand of the screen, that is the drone vehicle. Apparently, they are flying a drone out there. But one group of what looks to me to be FBI, because they're all unmarked, but there's also Northport Police out there. I'm going to turn this down just a little bit more. They have gone into the reserve and they are in two different groups. Hey, Jazeera, yeah, it is a great day. Thank you very much for joining. Jody PS from Belgium, thank you also for joining. Zach Lee, let's see, welcome back. I've come back to watch. Let's see. 12's my limit. I've come back to watch the replay, but just wanted to jump on and say hi, show my support, Gavin. Thank you very much. 12's my limit. Let's go ahead and take a listen to what they're saying here.
Police activity heading into Carlton Reserve. He sent over that video back to us here at WFLA.com. And then, of course, we mobilized Eagle 8 HD. Paul Lamison got in the air very quickly here and just arrived here on the scene about 25 or so minutes ago when we began
our WFLA Now live stream here.
So the activity that went in is the activity that you're now seeing here on the left side of your screen. So we'll hit the touch screen and go back here. And there's about 14, roughly 14 vehicles here that have now split up. We have one, two, three, four, five of them here
now. So right at that intersection right there, that's where the other group of cars
is. How wet this area is. But this is a roadway that, of course, that law enforcement vehicles are using here to kind of go through some of these swampy areas. But even there, on the roadway, you can see a lot of water here as well. Even though we haven't had all that much rainfall here over the last several days here in Sarasota County, Florida. So now we have two separate groups here. It appears a group of roughly five cars here, five vehicles here, and then we have another group of about seven or so, that's going to be nine vehicles in the other group right now, but we don't have eyes on that group at the moment. But right now it appears that there's a split here in the law enforcement search for Brian Laundrie here, and there is Northport police vehicles and then a lot of unmarked vehicles here as well.
So what has happened, from what I can gather, is there is a vehicle of interest in the park that has been seen and they're now looking for. They believe this might be the vehicle that Brian Laundrie has been using.
There's a lot of unmarked, most of the vehicles here are unmarked vehicles here. Of course, that leads you to believe that this is a lot of FBI vehicles here, but they are unmarked vehicles, and there are some marked Northport police vehicles here as well. So thanks to Jenna for the comment here. Amy Culver, hashtag AJB, lots of FBI, it appears. I hope they find him today. And yes, our commenters who have been with us here before on WFLA Now noting that if it's an unmarked vehicle, it's likely, of course, the FBI. Colleen Holly Saunders, hashtag AJB, Paul.
Let's pause that.
And
let's
pray
pause
they
that.
Find Brian. But
that vehicle that was just at the bottom of the screen, did that look to you guys like it might have been a white Ford F-150. Let me see if I can go back to that.
Unmarked vehicles here. Of course, that leads you to believe that this is a lot of FBI vehicles here, but they are unmarked vehicles, and there are some marked Northport police vehicles here as well. So thanks to Jenna for the comment here. Amy Culver, hashtag AJB, lots of FBI, it appears. I hope they find him today.
Guys, see that white truck right there?
In. Yes,
it looks like it's parked in.
Commenters who have been with us here before on WFLA Now.
Okay, so guys, help me out on what you think that might be. I mean, that could just be one of the vehicles that's there for the police. I mean, it's pulling a trailer. To me, that looks more like a Chevy than it does a Ford, but I don't know. I don't know. It could be.
Putting that if it's an unmarked vehicle, it's likely, of course, the FBI. Colleen Holly Saunders, hashtag AJB, hashtag Hey Paul. I hope and pray they find Brian, but sadly, I think he's...
Jay's way. I'm not actually live. I'm about 20 minutes behind. Are some of you actually watching live? Let's see if you have any comments.
Brian Laundrie is much more likely to be located internationally right now than he is here, at least... not even just in the United States, but here in Florida.
It could be a mowing crew.
I've seen some people saying Brian Laundrie could be right under the noses of law enforcement right here in Florida, right here in Sarasota County. Others who believe that he's in Mexico or Canada or located internationally here. Of course, we don't know what the FBI knows. And the FBI, of course, has the most information pertaining to what they believe are the whereabouts of Brian.
I think that we're going to get a lot of info on this. If some of you are live on WFLA, just let me know. But let's talk about this for a second, because over the last couple of days, we've had reports that he was up on the Appalachian Trail. We've had reports that he is in Florida. I even heard that somebody saw him in Montana, though I think that was kind of hearkening back to when... before he'd gotten to Florida. So the question is, where is he? And is it possible that during this whole thing, he is in the Carlton Reserve during this whole thing? That would just be something. Let's see. Lana Billings or Lana. I don't know how to pronounce your name. I'm sorry. Hope they get him soon. I actually woke up this morning thinking about the story. It's almost exhausting. Praying that this is the day justice for Gabby today. Yeah, I sure hope so. Marie, I pray they find him. You know, somebody was asking, it does seem like maybe there was a phone ping involved. J.S. Warner said that. Flip the switch. Oh, if he's pinging, he is not that smart. Lore M. Ipsum. That is a terrific handle. Thank you very much. He is everywhere. He is everywhere. Shout out from South Africa. Thank you for joining us. The trailer so he can load his kayaks. You guys are awesome. It might be a mowing crew. It might be somebody involved in the actual search. I just don't know. Melissa, YouTubers will find Brian. You know, there is something to be said about this. The fact that social media has kind of surrounded the family in a good way. Like they've decided we're gonna help take care of this family. I think we are making a difference without everybody talking about it all the time. He could just kind of you know, fade into the background, but we keep the story going. Hello from Germany. Frau Vorig, I don't know how to Vorigend. I don't know. Thank you very much. What? Let's see. J.S. Warner asked me what I think it means. Okay, I just think it means that they've got a credible tip that they need to follow up on. And guys, in investigations, there are a lot of dead ends. Like, this is something that the police, that law enforcement do. They chase something until it reaches the end, and so often the end is nothing. And yet, I think this is a good, what am I trying to say? This is a good commentary on who we are as a society, because we have decided as a society that it's important to spend resources. Sometimes the resources seem unlimited, though I know that they're not, on tracking down somebody who would murder somebody else. We have decided that that is something worth spending our resources on, whether that be time, person power, money, whatever, right? So it could be nothing. It could be absolutely nothing, but it's encouraging that they have kept the search going. Let's go ahead and go back to the live stream.
They have a gate and they have the road closed. So JB, that's what we're doing out here. Again, we saw a lot of stuff, but we didn't see a lot of stuff. So again, it's a huge area, and for us to just stay over it would just take forever. And we wanted to give you those pictures and let everybody know what's going on with the search, but the search continues out in this vast
thank
area.
Thank you, SD Surf Girl 60,
for
that.
And I'll give you one more look over to
so
the
that was
east.
One of the police vehicles carrying
That's
something
basically
that they
what they're
search.
Searching. This whole huge area out here. They'll continue to search
Thanks,
that.
Dear.
That's what they had the drone up. And once they have the drone, they'll have to bring it back and kind of download all the information out of it. And they'll watch the video to see if anything strikes them as out of the ordinary. And that's what they're doing. So, JB, this is your look at
hey,
the Carlton.
Pixie Mermaid, I think this is a very good point that you're making right here. In fact, let's see. Let me bring that back up. Sorry about that. Let's see. Where'd you just go? Here we go. The Night Stalker, this happened in my hometown and in my, like, very close to where I grew up. And Joseph D'Angelo, who ended up being the Night Stalker slash... Oh, you're talking about the Night Stalker. I was thinking about Joseph D'Angelo, who they called the original Night Stalker, right? But it's the same thing in the Night Stalker case, where the community has just said, no, we're having enough. Enough is enough. We're going to help find this guy. In the case of Night Stalker, man, they found him. They did a very, very good job. In the case of the original Night Stalker, who later became known as the Golden State Killer, it took much longer, but the community stayed aware. That was in my community. I have friends that I went to elementary school, junior high school with, who were neighbors of his. So thank you for that. That's a good point. Let's go back to what they're saying here. I'm doing this on my phone.
Can help lead them in the right direction. Now, Paul, this is Paul. Is that live? Is he headed back?
Paul is heading back here, and in fact, we'll throw up Carlton Reserve here, and we're going to start taking your hashtag HJB, hashtag HJB.
So the helicopter was only up there for a little while because they just ran out of fuel. You can't just stay there all the time. So let's see what some of your other comments. Let's go over here. If Brian Laundrie is in the swamp, I think he isn't alive unless he's been coming home to shower and shave. I don't see how that could be possible, right? I mean, the house has been swarmed with media and with protesters since, I don't know, mid-September, right? And I don't think that he'd been going home to shower and shave. I know that you said that tongue in cheek, but he might be dead. I hope not. Didn't they find there were multiple people involved though in the Night Stalker thing? No, I think the Night Stalker was just Richard Ramirez. Let's see, Patty H, New Year Channel, Gavin Lovett from California. The state is burning. I'm sorry about that, Patty. My parents are still back in Northern California, and a lot of my family, and it is on fire. Thank you very much for joining me. He must be found. That's enough with this nonsense. Thanks, Marie. Let's see, Golden State Killer and the Night Saga. Yep, I had the two confused. Thank you guys for helping me out on that. They're there for a reason. Yeah, I'm going to back up again to the actual, I guess, video from the actual helicopter. Let's go back to this. And again, guys, I'm kind of doing this on my phone and with technology that I don't normally use, but basically in this shot, they're moving from one group of vehicles to that intersection that you're seeing on the right-hand side of your screen that has another group of vehicles. And then when you go back out that road, there are even more vehicles kind of at the opening of the reserve. And these are vehicles that are FBI vehicles that are Northport police. Actually, we don't know that they're FBI. We just know that they are unmarked. And then there is a drone camera set up, a big van, like a Sprinter van, there as well. And they believe that the drone is going going up. Let's see. Let's see what else. Terry, this whole story has gotten my head spinning. Man, you are not alone, Terry. We're all spinning on this one. Man, I hope they find him. I really hope they find him alive, guys. I know that there are some people that have said things like, I hope he killed himself and just got it over with. I personally can't take myself there. I don't want that for anybody. But, I hope they find him alive. Joanne, you're saying he's on his way up to Canada, up the trail. Now, let me tell you my thoughts on this, guys. I just don't think that would be the smartest thing to do. Even if you're in a panic and, you're on the run, if you're literally in a town that is up against the ocean, right, the Gulf of Mexico, and you want to get to a place where you're going to be safe, I don't think walking or driving or hiking all the way up the Appalachian Trail, all the way up through my neck of the woods to get to the Great Lakes and then cross into Canada, I don't think it's the smart thing. And I personally don't think that it would be the easiest thing, especially considering that you're already on the water, right? You should be able to leave and go south. That's my thought anyway. So here are more pictures from the helicopter at WFLA. Zach, you would think they would take the parents into custody until he was found. So that's an interesting comment, Zach. Unless the parents have something that the feds can indict them on, there's no way that they can bring them in. And let's say that they actually were able to prove an indictment. They were able to prove to a grand jury that there's probable cause that they need to arrest the parents, and they get the indictment. The moment they pick up the parents, then that starts the clock, right? They have to charge them, and they have to begin the trial within 70 days. And I think that the feds, are very conscious of things like that, and they're trying to be as smart as they can. Now, the kind of bummer about this whole thing is that, meanwhile, the public is kind of not in the know. And I think from law enforcement's perspective, that's normally okay, because the public en masse, right, just in general, the public doesn't care about cases like this, normally speaking. Now that we've got so much attention coming from everyone, myself included, you all included, then the FBI and law enforcement has a little bit of a problem in that things are a little bit different for them, right? So I'm curious kind of the decisions that they're going to be making. You can look at the Carlton Reserve, though, man. This place is vast. I've thought many times now. I live up in the northeast of the United States, in the state of Pennsylvania. I was raised in California, and I didn't understand forests very well, right? I've gone out my front door and walked out into the woods, and I've thought many times, man, if I didn't want to be found, I could walk out of the woods and not be found. And the Carlton Reserve kind of looks like that for me. Of course, the Appalachian Trail also qualifies as that. Let's see. Olive, have you seen the close-up of the flower box in the parents' backyard? Looks like mom is passing something to someone underground. Can you see what that looks like? So I did watch that video, Olive. It didn't look suspicious. It looked like they were gardening. But, I don't know. I don't know. If they had like an underground tunnel or like a bomb shelter in their backyard, that would really be something, especially in Florida, where the elevation above sea level is so low. Thank you for all your hard work. Bless you all. Justice for Gabby. Thank you, Marie. I really appreciate it. Let's see. Prissy, paranormal. I think with his parents' help, he could be on the other side of the world. I think so, too. Now, here's the thing. I have a lot of experience in traveling. Never in hiding trying to travel, right? I've gone all over the world for business. And if you're going to go places the way that the rest of us go, that's going to be very hard to accomplish getting on the other side of the world. However, I have a brother-in-law with the most fascinating story of stowing away on ships and visiting different continents and different countries. And he spent, I don't know how many years of his life just going around the world without any of the official anything tracking him. So even in my own family, I know that is possible. And, you know, in the case of my brother-in-law, really smart guy and a really, what am I trying to say? He was a driven guy, right? He had ambition. But could Brian Laundrie be across the world by now? Sure. Yeah, absolutely. Let's see. They know something we don't. Thank you, Pamela. Let's see. He might if stayed close to home for assistance. He's craving sushi by now. That is funny. That is funny. I believe I have video of them eating sushi, which is probably what you're referring to. It's from this clip sometime. They were on this beach eating sushi. That's a good comment. Thank you very much for that comment. Let's see who else. Cat Dodd. I really hope he is alive so we can see his face, him face justice, but I have a feeling he is dead. And if he's not, his parents and his lawyer will have him well headed or hidden. Not sure I understand that last part of your comment, but I hope he's alive as well. Let's see. J.O., give up the idea of Carlton. The parents pointed the police in the other direction while he headed north. Wouldn't be surprised if he tried to make it to Canada. You know, you're not alone in that belief. A lot of people think that could be the case. The hiker in North Carolina that says he's 100% sure that he spotted Brian Laundrie along the Appalachian Trail. That's possible, right? It's possible that he headed north. I think that would be the most difficult thing to do. Let me see if I can go back to see if we can see these shots in the Carlton Reserve okay, that's the first group of vehicles if you're just catching up. Now, this is not live. This is maybe an hour or 45 minutes old. I'm just taking it from WFLA. And you can go to their YouTube channel if you want to see live what they're saying. But this is one group of cars. Let me pause that view real quick. That's one group of cars. And this van that's the second from the last in that line is a drone launching van or a drone control van. These are all unmarked vehicles. We believe because they're unmarked, they are likely FBI or federal of some sort. And then there is another group of vehicles, which I'll just let this go, that all are either Northport police or also unmarked. They are a little bit farther away. And then there are vehicles blocking the entrance to that area, like police cruisers that are blocking the entrance. Let me see what else. What about the Guatemala connection with ex-girlfriend? Okay, so I'm just going to apologize and not know if I just don't know about the Guatemala connection. Kapal, tell me a little bit more about that. I'd like to know. Because Guatemala would be a good place to hide, guys. That's a place with little tiny towns that are up out of the way. And you just have to learn Spanish. Nobody's going to see you on TV out there. Kim says, I feel like he's close to them. I think you're talking about the parents so they can keep him supplied up. I don't know how they could get supplies to him, though, with the amount of people that are watching them. JS Warner 13, does anyone know if this is an area they already focused on? I don't know the answer to that question, JS 13. Why don't we listen to what they have to say during this clip?
Our WFLA Now live stream here. So the activity that went in is the activity that you're now seeing here on the left side of your screen. So we'll hit the touch screen and go back here. And there's about 14, roughly 14 vehicles here that have now split up. We have one, two, three, four, five of them here now. You can see just how swampy, how wet this area is.
Carly,
but this is a roadway that, of course, that law enforcement vehicles are using here to kind of go through some of these swampy areas.
But that they thought might belong to him. Mari, hi from Italy. Thank you for joining us, Mari. Let's see. I'm going to keep scrolling through. Here, never wish anyone harm. He needs his day in court so the Petito Schmidt family has closure. I can't agree with you more. You guys, if you go and check out my video about Dog the Bounty Hunter, you will know why I feel about this, why I feel the way that I do. I can't wish self-harm on anyone. I just can't do it. It's such an insidious and hurtful disease. And in addition to the, to the experience that I've had with thoughts of suicide, I also have an uncle who took his own life and an aunt. So I just can't wish that on anyone. Isabel, thank you for that reminder. Let's see. Find him alive, make him account for his actions. Isn't it hard to get into Canada? Okay, Joanne, that is an excellent question. And let's go back to the conversation I just had about traveling the way most of us do and traveling the way like my brother-in-law did, okay? Listen, to get into Canada, especially here in the upstate New York area, which is what I'm most familiar with. If you go to Buffalo, New York, for example, and then up through Niagara Falls and into Niagara Falls, Canada, there are checkpoints. However, if you go up from Niagara Falls, just up the Niagara River, there are several little towns along the river and the lake, okay? And there are people that I know on the U.S. side, and granted, they have passports and they carry them with them, but they just hop in a boat and go and have dinner on the other side of the river. It's like crossing, it's not a big river. The Niagara River is not a big river. It would be easy enough to swim across, below the falls, basically, closer to Lake Ontario. It'd be easy enough for somebody at night to just swim across. So it would be easy to get into Canada. I think the hardest part would be getting from Florida to Canada so that you could make that crossing. I don't see how that makes any sense. Sheila Isaacs, if he is dead, we may never find out what happened. Sheila, my comment on that is that... I think that in this case, there is enough direct evidence and there is enough circumstantial evidence to be able to completely explain everything that has gone on. I really do. So if we never find Brian, or I hope this doesn't happen, but if he is found deceased, I still think that the law enforcement can put it together for the family. Let's see. I did notice that as well. I saw a vehicle with a hood up. It's possible something broke down, but also when my son and I go and fly drones, sometimes we will charge batteries on the battery of the car, so it could be something like that. Man, I am so far behind you guys on your comments. You're just jamming here. I hope he's brought in alive. I'm from Canada and the borders here are tightly closed because of COVID. So Lisa, that is true. At the border crossings, they are tightly closed. But if you spend any time in the Buffalo, New York area, I'm telling you, it's really easy to get into Canada. All you need is either a boat or, you know, some physical fitness. Chris, you're saying I don't think he's there. That's completely possible. Knox, pandemic protocol means he'd have to have a passport and vaccine proof to get into Canada. Yeah, at a border crossing, but I don't think he would ever try to cross into Canada at a border crossing. Everybody knows his face, especially in law enforcement. Dislike, who could it be? That's funny. Hey guys, just so you know, right now we've got 7 dislikes on this live stream. I personally don't like dislikes because it tells me the kind of content that you guys are looking for. So I don't mind them at all, but that is pretty funny. Could Brian Laundrie have disliked this live stream? That's pretty funny. I'm not sure FBI is as effective as it once was. Listen, I actually have some opinions on this. I don't know how much you guys want to hear them, but my opinion on this is, yes, the FBI, at least in the court of public opinion, has been damaged for the last few years. I think here in the United States, most people trust the FBI less now than they did 5 years ago or 10 years ago. And there are a lot of reasons for that. However, I have an uncle, my dad's brother, who he's my late uncle, not the one who took his own life, but who served as an FBI special agent for his entire career. And after he retired from the FBI, he was a polygraph specialist for a long time. If my uncle Leon is an indication of the caliber of individual and the dedication of the average agent, I would say the FBI is trustworthy to do something like this. In addition to that, my dad, about 4 years ago, a little over 4 years ago, was honored at FBI headquarters in Washington, D.C. For some community work that he had been involved in the Sacramento, California area. So my mom and my dad, and I was one of the kids that was lucky enough to be there. I got to interact with a lot of agents in the DC area and a lot of field agents that had come from the West Coast to witness my dad receiving this, you know, this, whatever you call it, citation or award or whatever. And in talking with them, I think that the investigative agents at the FBI are still completely trustworthy. They are terrific. Let's see. But I, Pamela, that comment, I respect the comment. Thank you for commenting. It will get colder and colder on the Appalachian Trail. Very difficult this time of year. Yeah. So I wouldn't say that I live on the Appalachian Trail, but I'm within driving distance of the section. I'm within driving distance of the Appalachian Trail. Here up in the north, up in Pennsylvania, the leaves are turning colors. The nights are cooling down. It is starting to get very cold. My question is, It appears that Brian Laundrie is somebody with some skills in survival. And I don't know. I think if he is on the Appalachian Trail, which I mean, you guys know where I stand on this. I don't think he is. But if he is, I think that he probably is. He probably is able to survive. Let's see, Gracie Rose Miller. If he's smart, he snuck into Cuba, and from there, no one would find him because he has all of Europe. Hey, that's a Gracie. That is an insightful comment. I'm going to go ahead and back us up again here, guys, just so you can see the footage from the helicopter. And hopefully, you guys don't get bored with this. But that the reason they're covering this in the first place is because a police presence rushed into the reserve. Getting back to Gracie Rose Miller. Yeah. Okay. So in and out of Cuba, it's really only out of the United States where it's hard to get to Cuba, right? It's very easy to get there from other places. So if he was able to make his way down the Keys of Florida and cross the Strait over into Cuba, yeah, then he can almost go anywhere. My belief is just because that would be the easiest way to get out of Dodge is that he probably went south, but that's just me. Let's see, broken justice. In my opinion, I would like for him to be brought in alive so that he can suffer his consequences, something he's never had to do. Well, I hope that as well. I hope he is brought in alive. Thank you very much for that comment. It looks like most of you guys feel the same way. Jackie, I want them to find him alive. I want answers, and I believe more of the family of Gabby needs them. That's good. Thank you. Joanne, no proof on the parents. So if the parents helped Brian Laundrie evade justice, and that can be proven, I think they will face those consequences. I hope so. Let's see. Tracy says, I hope they find him and throw the book at him and put him in jail for the rest of his life. I would say, Tracy, I would just add to that, I hope they find him and he's found guilty in a court of law and the rest of it happens, as you said. Let's see. Kim, no, I want him to face what he's done. I think you're talking about bringing him in alive. I bet he's close. Than the USA. Let's see. I'm not following what you're saying there, Kim. But yeah, I want him to face what he's done as well. Our Constitution does not allow the parents to be held until their son is found. Well, they certainly can't be held without charges and without probable cause. Man, you guys are so far ahead of me. Cat Dodd says, hope he is alive because I want him to rot in prison instead of getting the easy way out. Again, I want him to be found guilty by a jury of his peers. Guys, I don't know if any of you, comment down here below if you ever have. Has anybody ever served on a jury? I have been called in for jury duty 3 times. The first time I was actually selected to be impaneled on a jury, and I sat in a jury on a double homicide case, and it was about a 2-week case. My thoughts on a jury, on serving as a juror, okay? You feel so much, especially in my case, it was a double homicide. And so, in the state of California, he was a juvenile being tried as an adult. The prosecution was not seeking the death penalty on it, but at the time that this happened, the death penalty could have been imposed. And so as jurors, we literally felt like his life, the defendant, was in our hands. And that is absolutely weighty, everybody. It is extremely heavy when you're considering the future of the defendant. Now, after listening to the testimony and seeing all the evidence in that case, I was confident that he was guilty of 2 counts of first degree murder. Not talking about Brian Laundrie. I'm talking about this time that I served on a jury trial. But when we got into the deliberation room, I was like the only one, and it took a lot of convincing to get people to kind of my side. And I'm not saying that I was the greatest like convincer or anything like that, but it took a lot of deliberation, and most of it had to do with just how concerned the jurors were about having on their conscience that somebody could be either imprisoned for the rest of their life or be put onto death row. So I guess the only reason that I bring this up is if Brian Laundrie is caught, which we all hope he is, and he's tried, the prosecution has a heavy burden to prove beyond reasonable doubt that Brian Laundrie committed this crime. And it's an extremely heavy burden for them to face. It's a difficult burden to overcome. So even with all of the media scrutiny and people like me and you talking about this all over the place, there will be 12 people impaneled on a jury that have to feel comfortable putting him in prison for the rest of his life. Now, you and I might feel completely comfortable about that right now from our from wherever we are, right? But when it gets to a jury, that's a pretty difficult thing. Okay. I'm so far behind on your comments, I'm going to kind of skip down to the bottom here. Let's see. Is it possible at the Laundrie's house that there is a secret basement under the basement? Okay, so the answer to that question is yes. I don't even know that they have necessarily a basement. I know up here in Pennsylvania, I am sitting in my basement. I am below ground right now in my basement. If you go to the community tab on my channel, you'll see a picture of my office. And we have friends that have dug out even deeper root cellars, but the problem that many of them have is that we reach water very easily here, very shallow here. So I don't know. It's a good question. It's possible that they're hiding him. The other thing though, as I was investigating the case of Amanda Winkowski, which are videos that you can check on my channel, I talked with the chief of police who at the time, he wasn't the chief at the time because this happened back in 2008, but when she was a missing person, Border Patrol assisted them in looking for Amanda, either dead or alive, on the Tuscarora Indian Reservation up in western New York. They are able to, with their technology, they're able to see heat signatures even underground. So I don't know if a drone has been in the air above the Laundrie's house or a helicopter, but I doubt that he's at the house. Having just said that, oops, it skipped up. Let's see. Dallybone says he's in the attic. Okami asking, your basement or your mom's basement? No, I'm in my basement. This house is our house. That is funny. Thank you very much for that one. Let's see. BMX Jedi. Oh, wow. A BMX Jedi. Another great handle. I highly doubt there's a basement. I live in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Zero basements here because of the sea level. Yeah, growing up in Northern California, being in a river basin, we didn't have basements either. Yeah, you guys are all saying the same thing, right? Florida would hit water. There might be a few places that have homes with basements, but doubtful. Yeah, we should Google it. Somebody Google it. Let's see. It's not a good question. There are no basements in South Florida. Okay, well, then I stand corrected. What I called a good basement turns out is not a good question at all. Hey, here's a good question, though. How is a jury going to be non-biased? I've been thinking about this. Guys, so when Brian Laundrie is caught and the trial happens, that is going to happen in federal court in the District of Wyoming. Wyoming, I believe, is the least populated state in the United States. If it's not the least populated, it is among the least populated. And so I think that there will be a challenge in finding an unbiased jury. So it could very well be that that the defense makes a motion and is successful in getting the trial moved out of the District of Wyoming for that reason. Thank you. I believe he is at Sissy's house hiding. Pamela, I disagree with you on that. We did a live stream yesterday, showing, Cassie, and I believe it's her husband, James, talking to the protesters outside their house. To me, they came across as completely honest. They came across as honest. They came across as people who love Gabby, and she kind of came across as somebody who really didn't have what would we call that? A fraternal relationship with her brother. They're spread apart in age. I'm sure she loves her brother, but it's not like, I don't think that they were close. And she came across to me as somebody who is more interested in justice for Gabby than anything. I could be wrong, and you guys can beat me up in the comments for that if you want. But that's what I believe. Let's see. Raul, check the homes that are for rent around the area or empty houses, vacation homes. I think that is a very good point, Raul. I think that, I know in places where, there are a lot of vacant homes, places where many of the homes are second homes or Airbnbs or things like that, that is common for people to hide in those homes. So that's a good point. Storm bunker in the garden. You guys tell me, in South Florida, I mean, that's obviously going to be hurricane area. So they're on the Gulf of Mexico side. So maybe they do have a storm bunker. But I would think that police would have checked a storm bunker. Let's see. Lisa, I've given Brian being on the run a lot of thought, and I don't believe at 23 he will be able to evade the FBI for long. I sure hope you're right, Lisa. Here, I'm gonna go back over to WFLA, see what they're talking about here.
Here, we don't see the people out in the field searching. It's almost like, to me, JB, like they have something they want to recheck out. And maybe it's a good lead, maybe it's not, but they do have a lot of vehicles out here. Almost like a backup situation. They have the drone looking. We really didn't see anything in the area where the drone was flying. But again, this is what we're looking at. And this is the original area where the 15 cars were. The drone car and the other cars drove off. So again, that's where we've started. And I'm going to show you where the original area is that we start from, usually. The command center when the search was in full swing. Is right over here, and that's where they were parking. And this road you see out there is the entranceway to the park. And for us to just stay over it would just take forever, and we wanted to give you those pictures and let everybody know what's going on with the search.
I was muted. Sorry about that. Let me just respond to Debbie Baez's thing again. Sorry about that. Sorry. Okay. Here's a thought. You can take I-75 to its most northern point, cross over from Michigan into Ontario. Okay. My belief on that, sorry about that, guys, no sound, very sorry. I had accidentally muted myself. I think that the hardest way to get away would be by going north. I think that's the very hardest way to get away. So to me, I just don't feel like he went north. Let's go back to the stream here.
Together, and so that's kind of the northernmost boundary of what they've been searching. So, JB, I'll go ahead and throw it back to you.
Paul Lamison for us in Eagle 8HD. Paul, have a safe flight back to Tampa, and appreciate, of course, all the reporting and everything you're doing here from Eagle.
Sorry about that mute problem there, guys.
You guys have a good one, and follow me on Twitter. I'll have updates as they become available.
Eagle 8 HD's Paul Lamison here for us, folks. And just take a moment. Just look at this landscape here for a moment. It's vast. It's large. It's swampy. And it would take an enormous amount of time to comb through the entirety of the 25,000-acre reserve that is Carlton Reserve here in rural Sarasota.
Brian, or Bad Golfer, this is a very good point. He had no friend. He had no friends in New York. Yeah, they knew each other from high school in New York. So I think that's a valid point that I mean, maybe he does head north because that's where he's from. And he's from Suffolk County, as I understand, Long Island area in New York. So maybe he would go back to New York. That's a very good point. Still, though, I still don't think that I still think that's the hardest way to get away. The attorney knows where his client is. Parents give cash to pay him when they meet. New York attorney. Brian is in a home alone, orders in, and can hide easily. Real estate attorney will do this as long as money is there. So, I mean, I think... I just don't know what to say to that. I think that's a valid point of view, but I don't know what the ramifications for the attorney would be. That's Holly says, the bottom line is the FBI knows way more than they're telling us, so if they're still searching the reserve, there must be something. I agree with that. Let's see if... I'm going to skip ahead on this to see if there's anything... where they're back in the reserve yet or not. Let me see. Oh, they've got, that's the drone flying, guys. Let's hear what they have to say here.
Back and forth, back and forth. We'll follow it for a little while. Then it gets kind of hard to stay on it. But they monitor and they can do different type stuff with it. And it's a drone because it's unmanned, but it does look like an airplane. And I've never seen one of these up close. This is really the closest I've seen it. And so that just this thing just flies back and forth, and they're flying probably about, I'll move the camera out, they're not flying super high, they're just above the trees. So we'll watch it, and it just goes over certain areas. Now the difference with this and a regular drone can stop, hover, circle, and go up and down easier. This flies more true to an airplane, where it goes straight forward and faster than a regular drone, so it can cover a lot bigger area. And they usually, again, use drones like this for mapping and other things like that. But we're kind of watching it fly, but it's well below us.
He was saying earlier that a drone like that has a high-speed camera, and it's not necessarily broadcasting high-quality stuff back. They have to bring the drone in and download the footage off of the drone in order to see the high quality stuff. Of course, there will be video coming back in order to fly it, but the process is they have to actually download that from the drone as after it's made its voyage.
Now where they monitor the drone from, like when I fly a drone, I have to remain with eyesight on the drone. They don't have to do that. They can drive and wait. That the white van, now they're moving, and they can move with the drone, and that's kind of what they're doing. As the drone flies, they don't have to stay still. So now this vehicle, the drone vehicle that we showed you, is going to move, and it can move down to a certain area where they're going to stay. So that one's going. There's one more unmarked car going with them. The other vehicles are staying down at the site where we first saw them. So again, that drone will just continue almost in a grid pattern is what we call it, where if you take a piece of graph paper and you look at the lines on the graph paper, you would basically follow those lines back and forth to cover a specific area. And that's what it seems that they're doing. So I'm going to move and follow them because I think I saw one other vehicle with them. And sorry if you get seasick. This is kind of how we do it. I do see three cars. There's some other vehicles. So we're going to see where they go. We don't know where they're going. Again, we're doing just what you're...
All right, so I'll just come away from that for a little while so we don't all get motion sick. Let me go to a couple of these questions here. How do you know the kids didn't ask about her? Oh, this came from a previous quote or a previous comment about it was hard to believe that the kids wouldn't ask about Gabby at the family camping trip. Yeah, Judy says, I don't think the attorney will risk getting disbarred by helping a fugitive. I believe that the attorney does have a duty to bring in his client if there is a warrant against him. Dude, how can a freaking kid run from the FBI? Yeah, it's and that is a lot of why people are saying that he might already be dead. It's like he's so successful at this. I hope that doesn't happen. Let's see. He's in Buenos Aires, where everybody knows this case and locals hear people speak, where nobody knows this case and locals hear people speak other languages every day. Javier, yeah, I mean, as somebody who lived in Argentina, Buenos Aires is a port city with lots of people from all over the place speaking English and everything. It's actually pretty darn easy to get around in a city like Buenos Aires or Sao Paulo or Rio de Janeiro, places like that, speaking English. If you wanted to hide out in the Andes or something like that, that would be something different. But in large port cities in South America, it'd be pretty easy to stay kind of hidden away. I'm going to kind of turn this down while just so you guys can see what the helicopter saw. Let's see. There's lots of, man, live your life. They'll find a dead body, man. I hope not. And I think the Carlton Reserve is kind of, full of alligators and snakes and stuff like that. I think if he died in the reserve, it'll be pretty hard to find a body. About FBI activity in the Appalachians. I don't know. That's a good question. FBI definitely knows more than they're telling us. Now, this is another comment from before, Tammy. Another person made the same comment. If they didn't have credible witness, they would not have, you know, they would have, they wouldn't be back there. I think that's true. Lourdes, thank you very much for that super chat. Holy cow. Guys, my channel is monetized now, which is kind of fun. And I really appreciate the support on this because I do want to be a YouTuber for a living. I'm definitely not even close to that. I've been monetized not quite a week yet. But man, I appreciate when you support what I do. Thank you very much, Lourdes. I really appreciate that. And guys, there's no pressure to do that, by the way, from me. I want you to know that. You don't need to do that. But Lourdes, I really appreciate it. What do the parents do for a living that they can pay for an attorney? That is a question that I have never asked. And I think it's a good question. Does anybody know what the parents do for a living? I have a few friends who are attorneys who they will represent people who don't necessarily have the means to pay them, but they will put a lien on like real property, like a house or something like that, in order to make sure that they get paid. So it might be that they don't have the money to hire an attorney, but they own their house or they have a lot of equity in their house, or it could be that they make good funds and they're able to do that. Can a lawyer knowingly hide their client if there's a warrant, or are they liable to be charged for citing a fugitive or for hiding a fugitive, I think is what you mean there. So I don't know the law on that. I believe that they are required to bring their client in if there is an active warrant on them. That's what I think. Gavin, go please get yourself some mods for chat. Guys, I didn't think that I would ever I didn't think I would be in a position where I need moderators for chat at this point, but I will take your advice. I have one person who has volunteered for it. If you would like to be a moderator for chat here on YouTube, please go to my website, gavinfish.com. I'll show you. If you go to gavinfish.com, come up here, click contact. Just shoot me a message through here. That's the best way to get in touch with me. Okay. And Anthony, I will take your advice on that. Thank you very much. Abigail previously recorded. This was recorded about an hour ago, Abigail. We've been live for about an hour. So it's about an hour and 20 minutes old, I think. They're still talking about it on WFLA. Isabel, he's not a federal fugitive. He actually technically is. He has a federal warrant out for his arrest. So he is. Actually, maybe I should take that back. What is the definition of a fugitive? Is a fugitive somebody who has been convicted already? A fugitive, a person who has escaped from a place or is in hiding, especially to avoid arrest or persecution, fugitives from justice. So I believe that Isabel is correct. I believe he is a fugitive from justice. Let's see. If Brian is alive, they will not say all the places they're looking at. That is true. Rando Skycam. Hey, let's give you a little plug. Yeah, take your drone down there. Though, as if you are a certificated drone pilot, you will know, I bet there's a temporary TFR down there in the Carlton Reserve. I doubt you'll be able to do that. Just a little bit more about me, since you guys are following me, or many of you are subscribed, just to kind of get to know me a little bit. I am a certificated pilot, a private pilot, and when the whole new federal aviation regulations came out to, for unmanned aerial vehicles, I did get certificated in there. But other than just little racing drones that we fly in the park, I have never really used that for anything. Looks like Rando Skycam. Looks like you are probably a certificated drone pilot, and they could use your help down there, it looks like. Let's see. Brian is laughing at the police. Why are they still in the swamp? Hey, listen, they're in the swamp because I don't know this. My opinion, they're in the swamp because they have a credible lead, and that's what put them there. And I talked about this early in the live stream. Look, we as a society have determined that when somebody is murdered or is a victim of another type of violent crime, that we will, as a society, spare no effort to locate the perpetrator. So I'm okay with them being in the swamp, even if it turns out he's not there, if they were chasing a credible lead. That's how I feel, Alan. I appreciate your comment, though. Let's see. Can't they call parents for a lie detector test? So to our knowledge right now, the parents have not been indicted on anything. They don't have any warrant for their arrest. They certainly have executed search warrants there at the house, but I think that they could volunteer to take a polygraph test, but I doubt their lawyer would advise them to do that. Alan, good news. There's Jen agreeing with you, and Marjorie too. So yeah, it's not me versus you. You've got teammates there. Let's see. Goodness sakes. I think you're right, Anthony. I need moderators. Javier, just thank you so much. Let me see if I can add this to the Javier. Just did a super chat for $20. You are blowing me away, Javier. Thanks for the documents you loaded in the case. Thank you. I really appreciate that. If I can go back to my screen here for a second, guys. If you go to my website, go over to the cases page, you will see the four cases that I am currently working on. I've added Gabby Petito to it. Now, actually, before I click on Gabby, guys, these other cases, Shelby Thornburg, Amanda Winkowski, and Rochelle Brinson, these are fascinating and currently unsolved cases that really have gone cold. I've done the same thing for them that I've done for Gabby. Any documents that I have, I share and I make them available. If you go to the Gabby case page, I kind of hemmed and hawed about making it because it's kind of this case is live in front of our faces. It's unfolding live, right? So I didn't know that I wanted to do that because my other cases are old, but I did ultimately, and any document that I've found so far in the case, I've made it a PDF if it wasn't already, and I've made it available for download on the case page. So you can go check that out. In addition to it, I've added a timeline, and you all, I've really crowdsourced this timeline. So you all have done some amazing work in letting me know different things. And as long as I can find a source that corroborates that part of the timeline, I put it on to the case page. So go ahead and check that out. And then if you find that I'm missing something and you want me to add something to the timeline, or if you have found documents yourself, go to the contact me page and let me know. Okay. Just so this is a little bit of a sideline, but let me give you an example. Shelby Lynn Thornburg was Shelby Jean Thornburg was a young woman in Houston, Texas, who died when a John, her client, cut her throat. So in this case, I've published everything, including video surveillance on him, all the case documents that I have found. And once again, this one, I have crime scene photos and other photos of her. I don't have a very good timeline on that one, but you can see that that's what it is that I try to do. I try to gather as much evidence as I can on these cases so that it's easier for all of us to, to find the information. Let's keep this streaming over in here and I'll keep going through. Javier, thanks again for that super chat. I really appreciate it. Okay, I'm going to turn this up so you can hear what they're saying.
Off this transmission line, and I'll show you that as well. This is where the road continues, and what led us down here was they have the road blocked off.
I'm going to see if I can find
you here, and what strikes you as far as this uptick in police activity here at the Carlton Reserve?
Yeah, I think it's interesting. We've been out there every day for the last, 3 weeks, and there's been some definite lulls in the search, especially over weekends, especially over the last few days. It's something.
And I've seen the video with the flower bed there, the garden bed in the backyard.
Talk about the flower bed today.
Hey, Yankee Bell, thank you very much for that comment. I try my best. I will be wrong frequently, but I do try my best.
Light can be, you can reflect off of surfaces in a very, funny way. I'm not discrediting anything that right. Is seen in that video, but there might not be anything. Yeah,
just got to be cautious
there.
About seeing that video and thinking you maybe see a subject or thinking you maybe see the mom grab something out of the garden.
I'm going to see if I can go back to maybe some of that.
Vehicles here. So if you want to read more on that for yourself, it's on WFLA.com. And we'll, of course, update our timeline. In fact, I think that our WFLA.com timeline here with Gabby Petito and Brian Laundrie, that is all now up to date. So if you want to know exactly how this factors in there, you can go find this for yourself right now on WFLA.com. If you're just joining us, JB Buno here with you live, as well as Paul Lamas. This video and zoomed in so much, Josh, that I can see pixel boxes. I mean, that's right. How much they have zoomed in
and
here.
And when you're at that point, it's like, there's nothing.
These guys are doing the same thing I'm doing, right? They're basically just live streaming. I don't want to just, blatantly rip off their content, but yeah, the there is some, I'm going to go back again, guys, and see if I can get some of that, some more of that video of the aerial shots so that you know what's going on in the Carlton Reserve. Once my phone loads here, I'll bring it back up to you. Wow, this just does not want to go. Well, I'll wait for that to load and then I'll bring it back up here. Let's see, a couple more comments. Wayne the Sane, yes, you are right. My hunch is that the attorney coached them up on how to do this in an undetectable way, which is honestly pretty despicable if that's the case. Guys, I have an attorney friend. His name is Bob, and I was talking to Bob about, basically kind of what was going on in one of my other cases. It was the Amanda Winkowski case, and I was telling Bob that I wanted to help the mother of Amanda Winkowski get an attorney because she didn't trust any of the attorneys in Buffalo, which I didn't blame her for. And he was quick to say, well, you know, attorneys are like, if you go and you play basketball with your friends, I got some video back up. If you go play basketball with your friends, you want to win, right? I said, well, yeah. He goes, attorneys are like that too. They want to win. I don't think that an attorney for a client is going to put their license in danger. Like they will walk up to the line. They will flirt with the line, but I don't think that he will cross that line. That's just my guess. Hey, Gavin, this is Eric from school. Eric, like which Eric? If we know each other, Eric, you got to give me more than that. We are of the age that there were a lot of us, you remember, named Eric in school. Let's see. Juliet, the ballet mom, Vivers. I mean, as much as they're searching at that reserve, they must have concrete evidence that he's in hiding there. Maybe the dog sniffed out his scent from a get-go, and that's why they're still searching. I don't know the dog, the bounty hunter, was ever in the Carlton Reserve, but I take your comment. That's a good comment. Thank you very much. Let's see. What else do we have? Liz Ann responding to what I was saying about attorneys. That's right, they do. I want my attorney to win too. Attorneys are people. And look, unless the person you're trying to hide is your son or something like that, and you've got some other incentive, I don't think an attorney is going to give up his entire or her entire career and future by breaking the law. I just don't think they do that. Attorney is in over his head making mistakes. Could be. Could very well be. Let's see. Anthony Wood, my buddy who told me I need to get a moderator. I don't know what you're laughing at. Probably me, and I don't blame you. Where was Gabby when Brian flew back to Florida in August? Let's go to the timeline on that, because that was the 17th of August, right? So why don't we go over to the timeline here? We'll go over to my case page, go to Gabby. As we know from the statement that Cassie made yesterday, August 17th is the day that he was in Florida. So I still have to put that in the timeline, by the way. I've got a whole bunch of stuff to put in there. So on the timeline, we know they were in Moab on the 12th, and we know that they were in Salt Lake City on the 21st. My guess is when Brian went to Florida, Gabby was probably up somewhere in northern Utah in the Salt Lake area. That's my guess. Let's see. Nice tries. Responding to a couple comments about their lawyer's just a real estate lawyer. He says he does do criminal representation, but 98% of his business is real estate. He's also a real estate agent. Yeah, that is kind of interesting because lawyers do specialize in things. So if he specializes in real estate, is it possible that that he's somehow friendly with the Laundries and that's the attorney that they could get? You know, I'm not sure. Not sure about that. Let's see. Regarding the family, Jasira says, at the campground, perhaps Gabby wasn't spoken of because Cassie's kiddos were there and kiddos talk. They're school-age children with friends, and they may share with them. Yeah, I mean, let me bring that one back up and keep it up here. Okay, so let's go into Speculationville again here. So say the parents at this point knew that Brian Laundrie had killed Gabby Petito. Say that that was the case on September 6th through the 8th, and they're out camping, right? So they're out there planning if this were the case, right? And so it very well could be that they are going, you know, hush, hush when the kids are around. We don't want to talk to them about anything like this. They can get the word out. That's possible. Also, hey, let me tell you about an experience that I just had yesterday, okay? And this is a good metaphor or maybe a good illustration on the relationship between parents and kids, okay? I have, my wife and I, we have five children, two of which are in college. One of those two is in a college that's nearby. It's about a little less than an hour away from where we live. He, night before last, sent us a Marco Polo and said, I've been kicked out of my dorm. I'm coming home. So he gets to the house. We start talking to him, and he's like, yeah, so it's a COVID-19 thing. I keep trying to upload my proof that I'm vaccinated, but the system isn't working. And so they kicked me out of the dorm, which just sent me into a rage, right? I had to take deep breaths and calm down, right? So the next day I go out to campus and I'm a little bit upset, but I go to the health services area, and sure enough, his vaccination proof is in their system. I then go to the housing director, and I'm upset, you know, because my son has said he's been kicked out and for a reason that is, that I've just proven to my satisfaction does not exist. And after speaking with this director, it became apparent that while the system was at fault, my son wasn't telling me the whole truth either. He had been, the director had been trying to reach my son since the 22nd of September, and finally had just gone, okay, I've got to get his attention somehow, and he locked him out of the dorm. So while that upset me as a parent, I also learned that my son, who is a good kid and in general an honest kid, when he's in a position where he knows that he has some type of blame, he's not going to tell me the whole story, right? He's only going to tell me the part of the story that makes him look like he's the victim. So, okay, getting back to the point in all of this, did Brian Laundrie tell his parents, oh, by the way, I killed Gabby? Or did he say, you know, Gabby walked off with somebody. I have no idea where she went. She left me. We weren't getting along, but she left me. Or she accidentally fell off a cliff and she's dead and I didn't know what to do and I ran. You know, I doubt that he would come out to his parents and just say, here is what happened. I think that he probably acted like a child does, like my son did yesterday. And and probably not give them the whole story. And Andy Mia, you guys can beat me up for that one if you want, by the way. Why U.S. Marshals are not involved. My understanding is, well, actually, that's a good question, because the Marshals do have a couple of different functions, one of which is Manhunt, right? So I don't know. And actually, for all our knowledge, they might be involved. It's I'm not sure about that. Let's see. I've got one that keeps on coming up. TJFE had red truck covered with dirt, September 14th, Brighton End video. Any dirt roads in Northport other than in Carlton? Did parents give parents drive truck and Mustang there and now changing? Okay, so this is a video that I have not seen. I don't know about the red truck covered in dirt, but if you know of any other place there in that area that where there is a lot of dirt, why don't you put it in the comment for TJ? Let's see. Tracy says, I've been waiting for the marshals myself. Let's see. Arset Vegan? I don't know what you're trying to say there. Needle and Haystack, that's a huge area. It is a very, very big area, 25,000 acres. People have to remember they found a dead man there. The dogs alerted on that. I'm not sure, Brian, tell me more on that one. I'm not sure what you're referring to. Anna saying cannot have anything underground because of water level. Yeah, a lot of people are asking if there's a basement or anything like that. Let me rewind this back again so you guys can see the helicopter views. Since I'm not going on there live, you can see kind of what they were reporting here a couple hours ago. Patricia, I think the attorney is a longtime friend of the parents. That is kind of what it seems like, since he is a real estate attorney, right? That maybe he is a family friend. Hey, Gavin, great work on the Gavi Petito case. You have a beautiful voice, and you should be on radio or try voiceovers for Pixar or Disney. Been following this story all the way from South Africa. Thank you, Jeanette. I appreciate that. I have been told that people like my voice. My dad is somebody who is asked to narrate things quite a lot. Thank you for that comment. I appreciate it. BMX Jedi, U.S. Marshals search for escaped prisoners. Yeah, they do that. People who are on the run, they do that. I think they might also help in other manhunts as well. Bad golfer, she was in hotel. I think you're talking about the 17th of August. I think she probably was at, that is around that time that she was in the hotel there in Salt Lake City. Dana, people just want him caught so we can know the final truth of what happened. Yeah, now I think that we are all going to have to come to terms with understanding that we are not going to know everything that happened for a long, long time. We went over this in another video, but here's how it breaks down in federal cases. As soon as they basically charge him, he has a right to a speedy trial. And there are two portions of that. Let me bring that up here real quick so you guys can see. Give me just one second. But I covered this in another video. Let me see if I can bring up this document. I think this has to do with speedy trial. Yeah, here we go. Okay. So the reason that the reason I think that they charged him with a different crime is because of this case or this law. Okay, any information or indictment charging an individual with a commission of an offense shall be filed within 30 days from the date on which such individual was arrested or served with a summons. Okay, so once he gets arrested, they have 30 days to file a charging document, right? And then because it's federal, the trial of a defendant charged in information or indictment with a commission of offense shall commence within 70 days. Now, typically, guys, you probably already know this, but typically defendants waive their right to a speedy trial. They would much rather have time themselves to prepare a good defense. But this is one of the main reasons that that I think that they're charging him with something else, because they want a long time to be able to gather evidence in this case, and then he'll be charged. Assuming they bring him in and they bring him in alive, it's going to be a long, long time. Alma, you're saying she was in Salt Lake City at the hotel. Thank you very much. That back on the 17th when he was in Florida. Thank you. Pamela says the same thing. Let's see. I'm going to skip down to the end. Sorry, guys. Let's see. Music Calgary does not like what I'm doing. And people are coming to my defense. So, guys, look, not everybody's going to like me. I gave up on that idea a long time ago. But I definitely respect your opinion. And if you don't like it, you can just turn it off. That's perfectly fine. Let's see. Holly, what did you say? If there's nothing to hide, then you hide nothing. His parents know way more than they're telling anybody. You do not show up at home without your fiance, and parents don't ask questions. I mean, Holly, you're not wrong that you're supposed to be on this long trip with your fiance, the person that you profess to love, and you ask to come home or you show up at home or whatever. They will be asking questions. My input on that, though, is that likely he's not going to give them the whole truth. Tina asking, what do I think about her being pregnant theory? I think I've proven that I don't mind going into speculation town. So I try not to. I try to follow the evidence. I don't know what that would mean. If she did end up pregnant, would that mean that he would get upset enough to kill her? I don't know. You guys are coming to my defense. That is appreciated and not necessary. It's perfectly fine for him to not like me. Let's see. Jasira, speedy trials also don't allow enough time to process some evidence that requires more time to complete. That is true. Thank you. Let's see. Gracie Rose Miller says, I think they had a fight and he left and then he came back. He should have stayed in Florida. That's a good idea. That's a good thought. Maybe they had a huge fight and he said, Mom and Dad, I need to come home. I need to get away from Gabby. He comes home. He takes a breather and then he goes, okay, I'm feeling better. I love her. I don't, I'm going to, cause guys, listen, I have kids this age. The foolishness of youth is a real thing. I'm not calling them dumb. I'm not calling them stupid. The foolishness of youth is a real thing. If that were the case, Gracie, then you're right. Had he stayed in Florida, then Gabby might be alive. Alex, do we know if the family attorney was representing Brian Laundrie before he went missing? I do not know the answer to that question. I do know the answer to that question because the family attorney was representing the family on the 11th of September, and it was originally stated that Brian Laundrie went missing on the 14th, and now he's saying it's the 13th. I think so. Lisa, yes, I do need mods. I think I'm going to take your advice on that, everybody. Arrest the parents for holding information and maybe he might come from hiding. The bummer of that, Jessica, is that's what we want to happen, right? It's like, it's almost like, don't be upset about what I'm about to call this, but it would take his parents hostage to make him come out, right? Of course, that's not what you're saying, but that's kind of the idea. Unfortunately, they can't do that unless the parents are indicted on something. And that's just the way it is. Let's see. Hey, Gavin sent you an application to be a mod. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Okay, going back to the red truck, Eve saying it wasn't covered in dirt, just like it'd gone through a mud puddle. Okay. If Brian Laundrie is guilty, why did he openly drive the van home, not hide it, and leave a trail of bank cards? In my opinion, there is more going on than simple guilt or innocence. Excuse me, guys. I need a drink. Let me bring that back up, and let's consider this from Anna. If Brian Laundrie is guilty, why did he openly drive the van home, not hide it, and leave a trail of bank cards? In my opinion, there is more going on than simple guilt or innocence. Well, Anna, I think that we can agree that there is more going on here. I think if I were to play devil's advocate about what you're saying here, is I would probably say panic or something like that. But I think that we can take your point that there probably is a lot going on. Sophia, people always speculate pregnancy when a woman gets killed. You know why that happens, Sophia? And it's because so many women are killed because they get pregnant. And that's a sad truth. But it doesn't mean that it's always the case, right? Let's see. Yeah, and Chris, you're agreeing with Sophia. It's true, and that is true. I say murder weapon is burnt, melted, destroyed. It is my belief, and if you have seen my my previous video on this, it's my belief that she was probably shot. That is only my opinion and my belief with the facts as I know them currently. I think, yeah, she was probably shot, and I wonder if he's not smart enough to take the advice of not driving the van home and not using her bank cards, right? Is he smart enough to destroy the weapon, or would he just discard it somewhere along the way? Let's see. Does anybody believe that Brian killed the women in Moab and the guy in Jackson? I don't have an opinion on that quite yet. And Tortuga, yeah, we don't have enough information, only speculation, some really crazy speculation. And I am guilty of that in this case. I have been speculating for sure. Let's see. He most likely told his parents that Gabby was mentally unstable and he accidentally killed her in self-defense. Though that is so the opposite of what happened. It was brutal. I mean, that's just as good a guess as any other guess. Again, going back to the experience that I just shared with my son, kids make up stories. Actually, you know, that's kind of the benefit of being old like me. We remember being young, right? Right? We make up stories. Too skinny to be expecting a baby. Yeah. I don't know that I want to get into that theory anymore. Guys, I guess, you know, we've been going at it for about an hour and a half. I really appreciate you coming on and talking to me. I think that's probably enough. We're just really gotten into speculationville. What we do know is that police, law enforcement, which could include the FBI, which could include, which does include Northport PD, and could include the marshals, could include a whole bunch of different federal law enforcement organizations, are in the Carlton Reserve. We have video of them in there, probably because they have a really good tip. So I think that's probably where we should leave it. I really appreciate you guys following along and watching when I post a new video or do a live stream. If you have any thoughts about, you know, what part of this case you have questions about that haven't really been covered other places and you'd like me to cover them, again, head on over to my website. Where is it? Let me go to my website real quick. Head on over to my website and click on contact and get in touch with me and give me. And the other thing is, people have been claiming in comments recently that they have inside information, and because the inside information they have, then, you know, such and such. If you have documentation that would lead all of us to, you know, well, that would give us more information, and you want to share it anonymously, None of these fields on my contact form, none of them are required except your question or comment. You don't need to give me your name. You don't need to give me your email address or your phone number. You don't have to do any of that stuff. If you have documentation that you want me to see and want me to report on, then please deliver it my way. And I will do that. If you would, guys, actually, while you are at the website, please take a look at these other cases that I'm working on. These are ones that I've been working on. The Amanda Winkowski case I've been working on for since last November, and we've actually made some real headway on this case where we are now in a lawsuit with Erie County, New York, over their handling of her autopsy. We believe that I have proven to Erie County and to the medical examiner's office that she could not have died the way that she did. And now we're doing a lawsuit where we're asking a judge to compel them to consider the evidence that I have presented to them. And all of that is documented on her case page and in all the videos that I've done on her case. So please check those out. Have a look-see at the work that I'm doing. I am going to continue on the Gabby Petito case for sure. I'm not going anywhere on this case, but I also have other cases that I'm really diving deep into, and I would really appreciate it if you would check those out. So I guess with that, I shall bid you adieu, and I will see you on the next video. Take care, guys. Thanks for joining today. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you liked what you saw, please subscribe to my channel. And if you have any comments or questions, please leave them below.